Hey guys, so today we're going to be dealing with the Unify controller and deploying this into a cloud hosted environment. Most importantly, we're going to be able to do this for $5 and complete all this within 10 minutes. So let's jump right into it. So the first thing that you'll want to do is go to lino.com. If you want to kick a few bucks to our channel, click the link in the description and it will throw some money our way, but no pressure on that. The most important thing is that if you go to the pricing section, you can see that we can get a server for $5 per month and at a 1 gigabyte of RAM level, which is the exact minimum requirements that I would recommend for running a Unify server. So sign up, create your account, and once you're ready to sign in, get logged in, and the first thing that you'll want to do is select the 1024 package and choose the location of your choice. I'm just going to use Fremont, California for right now. You can see my Linode's now being created, but we need to go in and actually deploy an operating system to it. So click on deploying image and then select Ubuntu 16.04. This is the operating system that you want to use. Not a bad idea to bump up the swap disk either, and choose a secure password for your root password. So you can see the disk being created in the job queue at the bottom. But what we'll need to do is also power on our server. Press the boot button to make this happen. You can see the server is now booting and we'll need to wait for a success message to appear in order for us to connect to our server. Awesome, so now my server is ready for connection. I can click on the remote access tab and I can get the IP address of the server right here. Copy that IP address down because we'll need it to connect. Next thing we'll want to do is open up a terminal. Now that we have our terminal open, we can use the command ssh root at the IP address of our server. This message here is to just prevent man-in-the-middle attacks in the future. Since this is the first time we're connecting to this server, it's going to ask us to validate the identity. Just press yes and it should not ask us for the server anymore. So before we get started with anything, we need to upgrade the server. And unfortunately, to do that, we have to fix a bug right away. There's an issue with the Linode machines. They use IPv6 by default, and if they try to connect to the Ubuntu repository servers, some of them have issues if you're using IPv6. So we need to force the app package manager to talk on IPv4. To do that, we just type in nano, and then we're going to modify this configuration file. Paste in the configuration line that I gave you in my code snippets, and then press Ctrl O to save and Ctrl X to close out. Now that this server is ready to communicate over IPv4 for any apt updates, we can run apt update and apt upgrade. This will run two commands in once. It's going to update all the packages available through apt update, and apt upgrade will run the actual upgrade command. Press Y to accept the defaults because this is going to install a lot of upgrades for the packages that are on the server. If you get a grub configuration question, just press install the package maintainer's version. Awesome, so my base server is upgraded, but it's always a good idea to reboot the server before we move forward. We can check the server while it's rebooting to see when it comes up by just sending a ping command to it. And we'll start to see responses once it's back online. Cool, so my server is now back online. I can press Control C to get out of this and arrow up to SSH into the server again. Great, so now that we have the server upgraded, our next step is to add the Ubiquity repository. We can do that by echoing out the repository URL into our local apt sources list. Now that we have the source configured, we need to download the GPG key to make sure that when we communicate with the Ubiquity server, that the identity is actually validated. Paste in the command that I gave you. Now that everything's set up, we can just run an apt update. And let's join this so we can run two commands in one. And let's do apt y to not prompt us for anything, install Unify. That's the package name that we need to install for the Unify controller. Awesome. So now everything's installed. Let's switch back to our Linode manager and recopy this IP address because we're going to need it. If I open up a new web browser tab, I can do https://, and paste in the IP address, :8443. That's the default port that the Unifi controller listens on. By default, it uses a self-signed certificate. That's fine. We're just going to want to show details and visit website. Now we're going to configure the controller through the Unify setup wizard. Most defaults should be okay, so you should be able to just press next on this and go to the next page. On configure devices, we're not going to deal with any devices right now, so let's skip this for now and press next. Same thing with Wi-Fi, let's just skip this. So when we get to the controller access, you'll see that you'll create your super administrator up here at the top, but down below you'll see a device authentication, and it has a username in here already and a password that's already generated for us. So this password is actually sent to your local Unify devices and is shared across every single device if you do like local SSH to them or anything like that. If you want to change this, you can, but usually the default is secure enough and works pretty well. So fill in the information and then press next below. Great, so we have everything set up. Press on finish, and when it asks you for the cloud login, we're going to do that later as well. Sign in with the account that you just created. And the first thing you'll see is a pretty empty controller, but that's fine. The most important thing that you should just to familiarize yourself with the controller is that you can have different sites and locations. So by default, they cleverly make you a default site, and you can add other sites or locations as needed. So if you need to do an office, you can get that created. And the most important thing when you're looking at sites is if you go down to the settings, we have the top half here that relate to the site and the bottom half that relate to the actual controller itself. That means all locations. So you can go into a wireless network and call this office and give it a password of super secret, save this, but when we switch to the default site, you can see that that wireless network is no longer there. So that's the most important thing of kind of just when you're looking at settings and how this is organized. I believe Ubiquiti has done an amazing job at putting this controller together, and they made it really easy for you to upgrade this on your own as well. So if you need to run any upgrades, you just switch back to your terminal and run apt update and apt upgrade, and it will run the upgrade process. Obviously, since we just installed this, it's going to say zero upgraded, zero newly installed, but that's the only command that you'll need to run any upgrades on your controller itself. So moving forward in our next video, we're going to take a look at how to add devices and start to play around with these settings, but at least you know how to create your own cloud-hosted controller, and this is going to help out a ton when we finally get to the management side of things and automatically deploying the devices on our local network. So that's all for today's video. If you liked the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button down below. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Any questions, feel free to hit us up on Twitter at @serverSideUp. You can also follow me personally at JD Rogers, or just leave a question or comment down in the comment section below. Thanks again. See you next time.